The Krewe of Bacchus Mardi Gras Parade is considered one of the biggest in Mardi Gras, New Orleans. Is it also the best? Stay tuned to find out. Coming up next. Hi fellow travelers, this is Ken and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360. Yesterday, on our first Mardi Gras night at New Orleans, we saw the parade by the Krewe of Endymion. It was an excellent parade for our first Mardi Gras experience. However, standing for hours to watch it was quite tiring though. Tonight, we are out to see another big parade, and this one is by the Krewe of Bacchus. However, this time we have splashed out and paid $70 per tax per person to get tickets in a special area where there will be seats and toilet facilities. So it's gonna be much more comfortable, I hope. Is it gonna be worth it? Let's find out. So we're here for Bacchus, and for Bacchus, we have bought the ticket to splash out a bit to get seats. It has been so uncomfortable standing all the time, and I'm so glad that we have got tickets for this one. Founded in 1968, the Krewe of Bacchus broke with carnival tradition by staging a Sunday night parade with bigger and more spectacular floats than anything previously seen in carnival. Now, with more than 1,600 members and 32 animated super floats, the Krewe of Bacchus is considered as one of the most spectacular crews in carnival history. Some of the parade's super floats include the Baccha-Gator, Bacchosaurus, Baccaneer, Corn Family, and Baccha-Whoppa. So we just finished the parade by the crew of Bacchus, and we got a huge haul of stuff. These are just all the beads. There are lots of goodies that we've got. I'll show you when we get back to the hotel room.
Look at my beads, I'm glittering.
So we've got back to the hotel now. Let's see what we've got. We got some balls. We got a couple of these shiny badges. We got skipping ropes. Got a stress ball. We got some socks, I think. We've got a bag. Got a couple of cups. Another ball. And more socks. Oh, a frisbee. Oh, actually two frisbee. A broken sword. And not quite sure what this is. Wow, that's a truly amazing amount of stuff. Overall, what do I think? The parade itself was excellent. There were a lot of throws. The riders were following generously. There were some issues midway through the parade though, when nothing came past for at least half an hour. A lot of people left at that point. But for those who stayed, we just got more throws as there was less competition. The parade's ticket at $70, was that worth it? It's hard to say. I mean, the seats were very welcome, but it was difficult to catch throws in the stands safely. The availability of toilets was very helpful, though. If you don't live in New Orleans and you are coming here for a once-in-a-lifetime experience of attending Mardi Gras, then I'll say on balance that you should get the tickets. After all, you've already spent a lot to fly here and staying in hotels that are charging you a lot more than normal. Anyway, I'll end my video here. Hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you click like and subscribe. I'll see you next time.